Hey everybody, AB here from B&H, and today we're taking a look at Universal Audio's AUX, which is a reactive load box. There's a lot of really cool things. Before we get into that, I want to introduce you to my really good friend, Oscar Bautista.
Hello, AB. Thank you for having me. A pleasure to be here.
Oscar is a great guitarist and somebody I have played music with for a long time, and he's currently involved in a lot of really, really cool projects. What are you doing right now?
Yeah, well, right now I'm a member of the orchestra for the School of Rock, the musical, the national tour version of that show, and I've also done Kinky Boots, as well as performed on Broadway here in New York City.
Sure.
And just a pleasure to be here to talk about the AUX.
Well, you know, it's funny because a lot of people, if you haven't heard of what the AUX is, a lot of people think it's just another guitar amp modeler, and it is so much more than that. Really, it's a reactive load box, which essentially means that it is designed to be used with your amp. It actually requires a guitar amp for amplification. And in addition to, you know, interacting with your amp, it gives you the options of emulating things like mics, room settings, cabinets, right? Delays, and of course you can customize pretty much everything, but this is a tool that lets guitarists kind of keep their amps rather than trying to find 1,000 different amps?
What this does is it takes that amp or the amps that you love, that you own, you know, like the one I have right here, and it gets the best sounding quality out of the amp, and it enables you to record. To record that sound with all the different mics and cabinet possibilities and positionings of room microphones that you may not necessarily have. So in a sense, it gets the best out of your amp.
Absolutely, which is important. If you're also curious about why there's a speaker on top of the AUX, typically, if you were using this box in the real world, as we are, you would most likely have headphones on because you're really using this mostly as a recording tool, and you would either use headphones with a direct headphone output here, or if you're using your DAW or whatever. We wanted to put a speaker here for the room so that we kind of hear the tones that are being created from the AUX, because just remember, whatever you're customizing in the software, which we'll get to in a second, that's not coming out of the amp.
You're right. It's not coming out of the speaker.
Only your standard guitar tone that you've set on the amp itself is coming out, but really it's all the customization within the box that's going to feed your recorder or your DAW. And I would say the four main features of the AUX would be attenuation, rigs, meaning that you can set up different types of rigs, modeling, whether that's mic choice or room emulations or speaker cabinets.
Right.
And lastly, user presets, creating custom presets and saving them. You can actually save 100 user presets. So let's start with the attenuator, which is labeled speaker volume on the front of the AUX. As a guitarist, what significance is that? Why is that important?
You know, a lot of guitarists, including myself, like to do is take an amplifier and push it to its max by raising the volume and making it break up, distort. And usually you do that by turning the volume all the way up, right? So now that isn't the best thing to do if you have neighbors, if you don't have your studio space or proper workspace where you can get as loud as you want.
Sure.
So as an example, here's like this is a sort of a normal sounding level, you know, not too loud, but good, but strong. But now say I'm recording, or I want to record this amp and I want to, you know, make it louder. In fact, I want to distort it. So I'll turn it all the way up. This one goes to 12, by the way.
It really does go to 12. It's not a joke.
So now we're going to hear a little distortion. So that sounds really cool, right? But the problem is it's too loud, right? So here we have in concert with the box with the amp, we can still record that sound, but we can bring it down so we don't disturb with this knob that AB he lowered it down
to speaker volume.
So that's a great option right off the bat that is pretty easy to get happening. And you know, here I am, you know, maxed out on my amp with a pretty nice tone.
Absolutely. And this really applies to the recording world too. I can talk from experience, having recorded a lot of stuff over the years in studios. Sometimes you don't have the space to record a guitar amp in a live room. Suppose the drummer is recording and you don't have a big budget and everything has to kind of be done at once. The bass player is in the control room and he's putting his part down directly through the board. If you had this at your disposal, you could literally have the guitarist in the control room too, cranking out the tone that he would normally get or she would normally get in the live room, but right there in the studio and not compromise the sound. So really, again, I think this box really caters to recording. I'm sure other people will find other uses for it, but I really think that it shines in the
room. Yeah, and that's just the starting place, really. The aux has that feature right up front that you can easily access on these knobs. But it's actually a world of possibilities that you can get into with the app that comes with the aux.
That's right. Universal Audio has a free downloadable app called Universal Audio Aux, and it is currently iOS and Mac compatible. We're using it with an iPad, which is really cool. The Aux has a built-in Wi-Fi system, very easily hook up, and then you can really get into the nitty-gritty controls of how to deal with customizing your sounds and your whole setup.
It also gives you a visual, which can be helpful.
Sure.
Guitar players like everything sort of simple. But it'll take you through all your different settings,
sure.
your cabinet and cabinet options, your microphones on the cabinets themselves.
Right.
The room mics, which is something that I really loved right off the bat, just because it really emulates what sounds like a real room.
Absolutely.
It sounded so real to me that I thought it was much more realistic.
Now, the process of choosing your own setup or rig, as Universal Audio so aptly puts it, is simple. And of course, on the front of the aux, there are six rig settings. And those work in tandem with the software. So if you've customized certain rigs, or even if you chose factory presets, of which there are many, you can literally just switch the switch on the front knob from rig to rig to rig. I could see it being a convenient thing. I mean, you've recorded a lot. If you were recording a song that had a solo section, right, and you had set up one of the rigs to be really your lead sound,
yeah,
you could literally just sit next to this thing.
And then just switch it, and then you're ready to go.
Right.
Instead of necessarily, So it's another aspect of it being easy to use.
We also mentioned before that there are 100 user presets, so you can customize this and have settings galore. I don't think you're ever going to run out of presets. And of course, the presets that we used that are built into the aux software, we found that some of them are quite appropriate just from the get-go. And lastly, we have modeling, which is Universal Audio's way of letting you emulate things like mics and mic positioning, room sound or atmosphere, depending on where you're recording. And there are also some speaker-specific things where you can break speakers up depending on which cabinet you use, and also create Cone cry,
which is overtones,
right,
that are created almost like a harmony sounding, like a kind of, not exactly a harmony to your notes, but
right,
you can hear some other sort of, like, overtones is what I said. You can hear that. It has great visual of these cabinets and microphones, and depending on which one you choose, each one has a little blurb that explains what you'll get.
So what we did was we created custom presets to allow you to hear what some of these different rigs sound like. And Oscar will play some material, and you can get a good sense of how different and how unique each customization can really be. Nice. That's beautiful.
Yeah. So that's a sound that we just put together really quickly, again, it gave us the different options of cabinet microphones, room microphones, and the delay sound that you hear is built into the aux.
And for a totally different sound, we wanted to give you something gritty and a lot more distorted. So let's listen to what that sounds like. Nice. Yeah. Very aggressive.
Yeah. So I mean, that's again the amp just kind of being pushed to its max, and choosing a few different one cabinet option and different mic options, and just a delay that we liked right off the bat. So we didn't even touch the delay.
Yeah, we just engaged it.
Yeah.
Well, guys, we really hope you enjoyed the video. I want to thank Oscar for coming by.
Thank you, AB, for having me. Thank you to everyone.
I appreciate it. If you want more information on Universal Audio's Aux, check out bhphoto.com. This is AB from B&H. We'll see you next time, and Oscar, take it away.